And this, I've never actually done one about the person who was with us the longest. And for people not familiar with the sequence, it's about living in a shared house that becomes a sort of inadvertent foster home come artistic community. And this, as I say, is about the lad that was with us the longest. Inside your head is a lost 10-year-old looking for a mother who cares in a normal way, not a twisted way. But the nice you inside your head got out less and less often, until the little kid that is nice in there was never shown at all. There came a time when I thought I hadn't seen it for so long that I thought it had died. It was only after he met you in a cafe and he told me that you still thought of yourself as nice. And I wondered about it again. But the thing about being nice is it's like what a teacher once told me about being friendly. I'm friendly, someone could say. Ah, said the teacher. But it's not up to you to say that, is it? I mean, the only people who can really call you friendly are your friends. So I would put it to you, how do you know that you're nice? When your mother and your neighbours and your siblings and even some of your friends generally call you a hard case, a bully, a moaner, a nasty piece of work, we are all nice inside our heads. I expect that's why serial killers are happy to kill other people, because they're sure they're the ones who are in the right and therefore that they matter and that other people don't. I expect tyrants think they're nice because some of them are nice to their own kids. Nice is as nice does. I don't remember you being very nice. I remember the foul atmosphere in the house. I remember being made to feel guilty about having to use the upstairs bathroom when the downstairs one froze in winter. I remember you bitching about us with the guy upstairs. I remember you criticising the floor for not being spotless, despite the fact it was your dog that brought the mud in. You, the one that spray painted things on the carpet without putting the newspaper down. I remember it was you that took every saucer in the house and left them out of doors for the cats who hunted the birds. And the birds didn't get much of them because you left them on the ground, so the rats got them. Until all but one, which I found some years later under a bush, was broken and smashed to smithereens. Our saucers. I remember the courtesy with which you dealt with guests and new people snarling at them as they went about their business, simply making tea or borrowing saucepans. I remember the respect with which you treated the place as you turned pictures upside down and left graffiti logos on doors and walls just to give this place the Doss House chic. The way you left tea bags in the sink to stain the stainless steel and scowled at me as I tried to wear away the stains with wire wool. Your delightful habit of never using the compost jar but always leaving teaspoons on it so they would balance and then fall off whenever anyone went past to get to the fridge. How could anyone forget your habit of shouting at people about cleaning cloths and throwing them away at every opportunity, despite not being the one who paid for them? How could I forget you threatening to hit me? I don't remember you being